The Palma Valley cuts across the top of San Diego County, running from the mountains to the coast. Four generations of Lyles have farmed here, but Andy Lyle worries that's about to change. He says the tiny Asian citrus psyllid is laying siege to his livelihood.
They'll land on that leaf, and they have a sharp mouth part that they literally poke into the leaf and suck the fluid out. And in the process, then, they can infect that tree, just like with a hypodermic needle.
The infection is untreatable and fatal. Citrus greening, or Huanglongbing disease, is already ravaging Florida's groves, costing farmers there billions. San Diego County entomologist Tracy Ellis says the insect that spreads the disease, the Asian citrus psyllid, is already here in force.
Whenever the insect arrives, the disease quickly follows. It was a 5-year gap between Florida's detection of the ACP and then its detection of the disease.
The illness has officially only been found in a tree in Los Angeles County.
And this is a really good sign.
Mark Huddle is an entomologist at UC Riverside. He suspects the local situation is more dire.
Given the vast numbers of citrus trees growing in Southern California, it is highly likely there are many other trees in residential areas that have the disease, but we just have not found them yet. But it is likely that the psyllid has found those trees that are infected. It has acquired the bacteria, and it is now spreading it to more and more healthy trees.
That's why entomologists are attacking the Asian citrus psyllid that spreads the illness. Huddle says a small wasp from Pakistan is proving to be a capable foot soldier.
They attack the nymphs, or the immature stages of the psyllid, and the females lay their eggs inside these nymphs. Those parasite eggs hatch, and then a tiny larva that looks like a little fly maggot just slowly eats the inside of the nymph, eventually killing it.
Extensive testing during an 18-month quarantine suggests the psyllid is the only food the wasp is interested in. Without psyllids, the wasps die out. And Huddle says they are very effective at seeking out and finding their prey. But a big challenge is raising enough wasps to have an impact. Part of that work happens at UC Riverside. Huddle says the work is slow.
We have to grow a citrus plant. Then on that citrus plant, we need to grow the Asian citrus psyllid. Then on those, we need to put the parasites, which attack the Asian citrus psyllid. And then about 10 days later, the parasites will hatch out of those parasitized nymphs. Then we have crews of people that are collecting those parasites out of the mass rearing cages.
Even in this small breeding room, researchers can still raise 6,000 to 10,000 wasps a week. Huddle says they use a nozzle attached to a vacuum tube to suck them out of the boxes. From there, they go into small vials.
Then we just open the lid. You can see that little piece of paper that has the honey on it that the parasites feed on. And then when that vial is hanging in the tree, the parasites come out.
But Southern California is a huge region. Huddle says just raising enough of the predators to be effective is a major challenge. And there are other obstacles. Grace Radabaugh is a California Department of Agriculture technician. She says the psyllids are getting help from Argentine ants. Those ants herd and harvest leaf-sucking bugs like mealworms, the aphids we're looking at, and psyllids.
The psyllid, the Asian citrus psyllid nymphs, are producing this sugary substance called honeydew. And when that honeydew is produced, the ants find it. And they feed on it and they take it back to their nest. And it's a food source for them.
And the ants will fight the Pakistani wasps and other threats to keep that sweet food on the menu. Researchers say the best thing the backyard gardeners can do to help control the psyllid is to focus energy on controlling Argentine ants. Meanwhile, San Diego County farmers like Andy Lyle regularly inspect their groves. They do what they can with pesticides, and they hope researchers find a way to stop the illness before it shows up in a commercial grove. Eric Anderson, KPBS News.